could dress up to get love. But guess what? I'm never gonna be that girl who's living in a Barbie world.
Hey, this is Corey, front of house with Daya, and we're here at Elitch Gardens in Denver, Colorado, and we're gonna talk about some mixers, specifically this one. I've been a musician pretty much my entire life. I'm a woodwind player. I've played saxophone and guitar pretty much my entire life, and I attended Capital University in Columbus starting in 2010, went through my bachelor of music program there, and today we're here supporting Daya, and it's been quite a wild ride just to go from small town farm boy to, you know, to be hanging with the big league cats. On stage, we've just got multi-pin subsnakes going local into the M32 monitor console. We've got five stereo ear mixes and a wedge mix, and the band each have a dedicated reverb routed to their ears as well that they can mix. And they can do their ears with their iPhones, and they can also do their reverbs as well. Pretty simple, just local in, and then AES 50A, 48K, all the way down to this guy. I take those off those head amps. I just have trim here at front of house, and I have everything pretty much routed one-to-one on both consoles to keep it simple. Beyond that, we are running a multi-rack native setup today, and I'm doing a parallel process of Grace's vocal just to use some of the stuff that I like to use in my studio sessions on her live voice. And it's been really great. You know, the card that these comes with makes it super easy. You can see here, it's one cable and a power cable to set up, piece of cake, and this console makes it super easy to do all that routing and to be flexible. At the same time, we're multi-tracking every show and using the virtual sound check features via the same card, literally one line for both of those. That's one of the features that I love most about the X32 and M32 consoles, is that they come equipped to be flexible, they come equipped to record, to do virtual sound check, for everybody to do their own in-ears. I think speed is the name of the game in live sound, especially at the level that we're at. You know, we gotta get in, get out, and not waste, you know, 2.5 hours doing sound check. And this console really makes it possible to get through some of those otherwise impossible days. I've had an X32 compact since September of 2013. About 8 months later, I got an X32 rack, and I bought an S16 sometime in between them. So when we take my desks on the road, I have a compact at front of house, which takes up this much of a footprint, stage box on stage. Everybody does their iPhone in-ears, and we also have monitor sends from front of house in that configuration, so I can do her ears from here, her wedge. So for Daya's vocal chain, we're actually running two completely separate chains. Because we're using the multi-rack setup, I've got some waves processing that I'm using on the card insert. For the internal effects, we're using, you know, just the channel gate and the LA-2A plugin on her vocals. As far as effects go, I'm doing kind of a 2-second room reverb along with a very lightly blended in slapback delay. I use that instead of a chorusing effect because it doesn't last as long, and I feel like it thickens up the vocal without getting busy in the mix, and it adds just a little bit of width as well. So do those reverbs. They're mono in but stereo out, and they have a left-right dispersion control in the plugin in the console, and so you can use that to create a little bit of width in that vocal without taking up too much space. Hey guys, once again, this is Corey with Daya. Thanks for watching, and we gotta get back to making some noise, but we'll see you guys around at a show sometime. Thanks.